plugged in.
Okay, we're gonna start drying now. I don't have a fluff dryer with me, but with her coat being, you know, fairly straight, we should be able to do it with a force dryer just fine. Not sure how she'll act, but what I'm gonna do, since she is a drop coat, is I'm gonna line dry over here, and then I'm scissoring her legs in a teardrop form that I learned from the Academy of Nash, and then I'll be drying her face, and I'll be drying it upwards, because I'm trying to get a nice terrier look, and have some volume up here, which you normally don't see. That's the way she's gonna be, so we'll see which way she acts. Hopefully she's a good girl.
Do you want a hand dryer?
Nah. She does have a couple little mats here in her sanitary area, which I'll be shaving out with a 10 blade. Okay. We'll be right back with the haircut. Okay. Time for the haircut. She needs quite a bit off her beard. What happens a lot is, the parents can't see the bangs, so they cut that off. So we're really just going to even that out. I'm going to start off with the sanitary. And I use a 10 blade. On the smaller dogs, and all the dogs really, I really like to use the 5-in-1s. It's a lot lighter, and I feel that it's not as noisy for the dogs, so they're usually act a little bit better on it. And it's also a lot lighter on your hand, so it's not as physically pulling on my body. Putting on the pads. She's got a little bit of dermatitis here in her pads of her feet. She has some allergies. I'm not sure if it's from the chemicals that they spray here at this homeowners association or what it is. Very good. Now her for body, I'm going to start off with a 2-comb, see how much that takes off. And if not, I'm going to drop down to a 4-comb. Again, on the smaller dogs, I like to use the 5-in-1. It's just a lot more lighter. And I think the dogs, oh yeah, the 2's gonna be fine. And the dogs seem to like it a little bit better. With every dog you have to take into consideration, every dog is different. You have to take in consideration of its conformation and the way that you can best hide the faults and accentuate the good parts. Since she's a little bit chunky, we're going to go ahead and we're going to outline her belly here to make her look like she's got a little bit more angulation than she actually has. Let me see here. Here we go. Now, if you've seen one side, we'll go ahead and save some time. I'm not sure how this phone works on this. Okay. Time to do scissoring and finish work. A dog like this that doesn't have much coat, I like to do what I call a teardrop leg. And it just leaves a little bit more coat on them. Especially for your people that want to have a fluffier dog, it takes the hair off where they mat the most, and then you leave the hair where it doesn't mat. So it's a lot easier for your clients that don't come every week or every 2 weeks. Also for the resort, it's a really good trim or a style of a trim for the dogs that are active and they're running around, they're getting wet and they have a curlier coat and they're gonna, mat up as quick, they're gonna mat up pretty quickly and whatnot. You're all right, Munchkin. have to forgive us. We're both quite hot, it being June in Florida, and the best lighting we could find was outside on this patio. So she is panting a little bit, as well as my perspiration. Okay, so those are her legs. We're going to go ahead and take a cold beverage break and cool down a little bit. And I'll finish her other side of the legs. I'll do them the exact way that I've done these. And then we'll move on to her face. All right, Munchkin, let's go get some AC.